down the guitar. Only two strings will be tuned down. Your top string, number 6, the lowest string, will go from E down to D. Your fifth string, the A string, will drop down to G. And the remaining strings will stay in standard E tuning. This is going to be a demonstration of where we're going. The segments ahead will take us there. With the opening, we'll use straight single note picking. We'll do that 4 times. On the 5th, you'll be launching into the melody. And as far as the fingering technique, there's no fretting here. You pick and choose the fingers you feel comfortable with, but when we get into the melody, we'll have to do some fine tuning. So here's the beginning. Times. Let's talk a little bit about fingering techniques. I prefer the pinky to be rested on the body of the guitar, where the pick guard is on steel string guitars. I like the control, the balance, and the precision that this presents itself with. Classical players probably feel suffocated by that. So let's move on into launching the melody. Now from the opening that we learned moments ago, we got to keep the same pace as we begin to put ourselves in a position to start fretting the melody. When we come off the 4th rotation of the introduction, we got to get our fingers positioned here. Our index finger is going to be on the 10th fret, 1st string. And our ring finger is going to be on the 12th fret, 2nd string. Our fingers will have our thumb on the 5th string, our index finger on the playing hand on the 2nd string, and our middle finger on the 1st string. So on the 4th rotation from the introduction, you're going to have to slip these onto the fretboard. Well, what I recommend is, after you've cleared string number 3, you're good to go, and you've got one string to play before you get into this position where you're going to pluck all 3. Let's examine the fret hand here. We'll do our 4th rotation on the introduction and get positioned for the 5th and for the pluck. One more time. Number 4. Time to get busy. Let's get our finger here, our index finger on the 10th fret, first string. Ring finger, 12th fret, second string. Thumb on the 5th string. Index and middle finger on the 2 high strings. Pluck. Release the fret hand. Then bring the thumb down to the 4th. Index, 3rd. Middle, 2nd. Index, 3rd. Then we're going to shift 1 fret to the left and have your finger number 9 and number 11, same position. Pluck. Hit the 4th string. Come back to 10, 12. Pluck the 3 strings. Run them down again. 4, 3, 2, 3. And then up to 7 and 8, changing the fingering from index to middle, pluck, and hit the 4th string. It'll sound like this. Here's another perspective. Focus on our playing hand. Our middle finger is going to be on string number 1, index finger on string number 2, and our thumb string number 5. Simultaneous pluck, and you release because you got some open strings to play. And we move that fret over to 9-11, pluck. Bass, back to 10 and 12th fret, fingering position, pluck, run them down again, 7 and 8, pluck, and hit the 4th string once again. Let's run that sweet, sweet melody all the way to the 7th fret. And you'll find that when we release the 7th fret, we're going to run that same sequence of notes that we ran in the introduction. And this is played twice, so anything that's played twice is nice. You've got to know that. So let's check this out. For some real fun. Let's go to the 7th fret and take a bar chord position. And we're going to fret from the 5th string all the way through down to the 1st string. So this low string is open. What we're going to do is pluck the 6th string with the bar chord, and you've got your middle finger on the 8th fret. Fingering again, it's the same relationship we've had throughout the song to this point. We're going to dissect this bar chord on the 7th fret. Let's put our middle finger on the 8th fret on the 1st string. And of course the 6th string is open. So we're fretting 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Second string is played with the index finger. First string on the 8th fret is played with the middle finger. you're going to pluck all three, six string, one string, two string, then thumb the fourth string on the seventh fret, pluck those same two strings on one and two with your index and middle fingers, release the eighth fret fingering, and pluck the first string of the seventh fret, then play the fourth string on the seventh fret, the bass note. Return your finger to the eighth fret and pluck strings one and two. Now you got to swing your pinky to the tenth fret on the first string and pluck strings one and two. Now for the big change, back to the original shape. We're fingering frets 7 and 8 with your index and middle finger, like we spoke before. And with your thumb on the fifth and open string, you're going to pluck those three simultaneously. And then run down from the fourth by releasing your hand. Let's try that again. Okay, a quick review on the bar chord sequence. 7th fret from the 5th string all the way down to the 1st. 6th string is open. We're going to put our middle finger onto the 8th fret on the 1st string. Then we're going to pluck those three. And with our thumb, we're going to hit the 4th string, 7th fret. Same two fingers, pluck strings 1 and 2, lift your finger from the 8th fret and play the 7th string, or the 7th fret, 6th string by itself, put the 8th back down, pluck up on strings 1 and 2, play the 4th string, 7th fret, and then get your pinky over on the first string, 10th fret. Pluck both of them. And now for the big shift, leaving the bar chord back into our original shape. We're going to pluck strings 5, 1 and 2, and run down with the release. So let's touch on this one more time, and this will be the final part of this segment. We're going to bar the 7th fret. We're going to put our middle finger on the 8th fret on the 1st string. There's the 7th fret. Low string is open. Put our middle finger on the 1st string, 8th fret. 2nd string, 2nd fret is played with the index. 1st string, 8th fret is played with the middle finger. Pluck all three, thumb the 4th string on the 7th fret, pluck strings 1 and 2 with the index and middle fingers again, release the fret fingering on number 8, and pick the 1st string 7th fret, sound the 4th string 7th fret, return the fingers to the 8th fret, and pluck those strings 1 and 2. Now the tricky part is to get to pinky onto the 10th fret, 1st string, sound those two strings, 1 and 2, with your index and middle fingers, and get ready for the big shift to the original shape, strings 7 and 8, index and middle fingers, thumb on the 5th string, which is open, pluck those simultaneously. Release your fretting position, hit the 4th string, 3, 2, 3, and get ready to get back to 10 and 12 and pluck strings 5, 1 and 2 on the 10th and 12th fret.